Hello and welcome back to my channel. Today's video is really exciting because we are doing a book haul. I haven't done a book haul, I think, in a while. I actually don't remember the last time I filmed a book haul. So this book haul is a little bit different than some of my previous book hauls in the fact that all of the books that I'm hauling today are solely based on your recommendations. So on my Instagram a couple of weeks ago, I did this really fun thing on my Instagram stories where I did a whole bunch of like surveys where you can like ask a question and have people respond. I said I was looking to branch out this year into some new genres. This is something I kind of did last year. I only just did it on my own, but this year I really wanted to push myself to branch out into different genres and different types of books, because when I did that last year, some of those books ended up being my very favorite books. So I had a really good time pushing myself to try new types of books. So I wanted to do that again this year. But when I'm branching out to a new genre, sometimes I get a little bit lost on where I should start, especially if it's a brand new genre to me. So I thought, why not ask you guys? So that's what I did. I went on my Instagram, I posted those little surveys, and I broke it down into each genre that I was interested in. I got a ton of feedback, so I compiled all the data into a massive spreadsheet, broke it down into the different genres, so each genre had its own spreadsheet, and I wrote the name of the book, wrote the author, and then I tallied how many times that particular book was mentioned. So if 10 people recommended the same book, it would say that, and then I sorted them so you could see which books were the most mentioned in each genre. I shared the spreadsheet over on my Instagram after a lot of you asked about it, and I also did a top 10 list in each genre that I shared in my stories. It was actually really interesting to see, and it was really nice to get an idea of what books you guys recommended in those genres, because they were some of the genres you read but I didn't. So long story short, I took all that data and I decided that I would try out some books in each genre based on your recommendations. So the genres I asked about were graphic novels. So mystery slash thriller was combined into one category. I also did historical fiction, I did romance, and I did adult fantasy. So those are the five that I did already. I do have some other categories that I've recently asked about, so I can update it, but out of those five categories, I picked some books that either sounded really interesting to me or were at the top of the list that I didn't already own. Basically, to summarize, I asked you guys for recommendations for books in certain genres. You delivered a whole bunch of responses, and from those responses, I chose some books to purchase so that I can expand my reading horizons and read some new genres this year. Some of the books that were at the top of the list I already own and plan on reading this year, so I didn't purchase them, obviously. So I don't have something for every category, but I did want to share with you the ones that I did pick up in case you're interested to see the books that I hauled based on your recommendations. So if that's something that you're interested in seeing, just keep watching and we're going to jump right into this book haul. So the first genre we're going to talk about is graphic novels. This is pretty much a brand new genre to me. I have barely scratched the surface on graphic novels. A few years ago, like probably like 5 years ago, I read the entire collection of the Batgirl comics because Batgirl was my favorite female superhero at the time, and so I read through all her graphic novels, so I am familiar a little bit, but I feel like superhero graphic novels are a little bit different, so I wanted to expand and kind of get more into it. I've heard really good things about some graphic novels, and like I said, I'm just trying to read some new things, see what I can learn from them. Graphic novels is one genre I'm really unfamiliar with, so I asked for your recommendations and you guys really delivered, and so I actually picked the two recommendations that were the very top of the list of your recommendations. So these were the most recommended. I got this recommendation over and over again. I think each one, the first one got well over 30 recommendations and the second one was well over 20. Highly recommended and I'm really excited to check them out. So the first one that I picked up is Saga. I don't really know how to say it, I'm sorry. This is just volume one. I got volume one of each one so that I can see if I like it before I continue with the collection. I'm really excited about all of the artwork. I'm really excited for the story. This graphic novel follows two soldiers who are on opposing sides who fall in love and have a family and kind of need to like navigate what that looks like when they're on opposing sides and trying to protect their family. So I'm really interested in the story. I know this is like one of the most popular graphic novels, so I'm very excited to check this one out. And the second one I got is called Heartstopper. This one is a like contemporary graphic novel. I'm really excited about the art in this one. It looks really sweet and really endearing. So I'm really looking forward to this one. This one pretty much sold me, mostly because of all the recommendations, but also it just sounds really cute. It is two boys who become friends and then fall in love, and I think that it sounds absolutely adorable. And I also think that they just announced this is going to be a Netflix show or something. I feel like I heard something about that. I'm very excited to check out both of these because they come so highly recommended, and I think it will be nice to have one fantasy one and one contemporary one to kind of see what I like about each one. So the next genre of books that I got your recommendations for is mystery slash thriller, which again is a very new genre for me. I think I've mentioned this a few times before, but I am a big scaredy cat. I don't like being scared. I don't like scary movies. It's just not for me. Like, I get scared at everything. I've never explored this genre very much. There have been a few ones, like, over the years. I read a couple as a teenager. Maybe, like, a YA one, like, in my adult life. But it's really a new genre to me. It's not something I ever pick up. But like I said, I want to expand my horizons this year, and I thought I should give it a try. So I again asked for your recommendations, and again I selected the top two recommendations. So the first recommendation, which was very top, it was recommended 27 times, and that is The Silent Patient. I actually am really intrigued by the synopsis, and it's also a psychological thriller, which when it comes to mystery slash thriller novels, I feel like the psychological ones are the ones that I could maybe handle. I have read a couple. I read Verity by Colleen Hoover, and I did enjoy that. It was very messed up, but I got through it. I think out of anything, psychological thrillers, I could kind of find my way with. In this one, the plot really intrigued me. A wife ends up, she has like this kind of seemingly perfect life, and one day her husband comes home and she kills him, and then she stops talking. And this psychologist is basically trying to uncover what happened, why she did that, why she stopped talking. I don't know that much about it. Based on how many people recommended this, it's a good place to start in this genre. And the second suggestion was an author suggestion. A lot of you recommended Riley Sager. I don't know how to say the last name, sorry. I had over 20 people recommend just that author. They have a lot of books. I didn't know where to start because there were so many books by the same author. So I did reach out to a friend who I know has read pretty much all of their books, and I asked where's a good place to start, and I went off of that recommendation. So they recommended I start with The Last Time I Lied. This is, again, kind of a psychological thriller. It takes place at a summer camp. I don't know that much about this one. I am solely going off of this person's recommendation to start here. I also feel like with this genre, it's okay to go in blind because I feel like that would add to the mystery and thrill of it all. So I don't know that much about it, but I am excited to read this author. I see this author everywhere. I'm pretty excited to check out both of these. Let me know if you have read any of these or if you agree with these recommendations. Obviously, please keep this spoiler free, but I'm interested to hear your thoughts on mystery slash thriller. I know it's a very popular genre. The next book that I have hauled is a little bit different because it wasn't on that spreadsheet because it's a YA book. But I did pick this up based on a recommendation, in fact, multiple recommendations, so I'm going to include it in this haul. So in January, I read the book Grown by Tiffany D. Jackson, which was really good. It's kind of a YA thriller of sorts, but I really enjoyed it. As difficult of a book that was to read, it was really important and it was really good, and It was, like I said, it was really hard to read, but I did really like the thriller element of it. It kind of kept me reading. I ended up reading that book really quickly. I mentioned this all on my Instagram while I was reading it, and I had so many people reach out to me, including a really good friend of mine, and say that her other books were also really good, and specifically everyone mentioned Monday's Not Coming. I don't know anything about this. I didn't read the synopsis, but so many people told me that if I liked Grown, I should read this one. So I picked it up and I'm really excited to give it a try because I really enjoyed that one and I really enjoyed her writing. Also picked this one up, and because it is kind of a thriller-ish, I'm gonna throw it into this category. So the next two books that I hauled in January are both adult contemporary romances. This genre is not a new genre to me. I have dabbled in adult contemporary romance for the last few years. I really enjoy them every now and then. I did ask for your recommendations because I'm always looking for new ones to try. A lot of the ones that were at the top of the list were ones I've already read. A lot of them were authors I've already read, so I didn't end up picking any of those, but I did go through the list and pick a couple that I hadn't read yet that sounded really interested and they were recommended a few times. The first one that I picked up is How to Fail at Flirting. This one, it has to do with a professor who's like very type A, and she decides to go out for a night in town with some of her friends, and she has this kind of to-do list that is just like fun, like get a guy to buy her a drink, that kind of thing. So she ends up meeting a guy at this bar, and then they end up kind of like developing a relationship after that. You know, the story goes from there. But I am really excited for this one. This one seems like a little bit more serious than the other one I picked, so I kind of like that I have a little bit of a balance, and I've heard it has some nice banter in it, which is always a bonus in my books. The second romance that I picked up was one that was really highly recommended, and I hear about it all the time, but I haven't read it yet, and that is Well Met. And this one is a, I believe it's an enemies to lovers book, which is always a fun genre to read. But this one, the like main thing about it is that it takes place at a Renaissance fair. So I'm interested to see what that's like. I've heard so many people talk about this. In fact, it is blurbed here by Christina Lauren, which is one of my favorite authors in this genre. So I feel like it's gonna be good. This one I think is a little bit lighter, a little bit funnier, so I think it will be nice to have a bit of a balance. I'm really excited to check these out. I always like having something cute to read on hand, so I'm glad to pick these ones up. The next category I asked for recommendations was actually historical fiction, but I owned like a lot of those, so I didn't pick any of those up. So we're gonna skip ahead to adult fantasy. This is not a genre that I'm unfamiliar with, although it is something that I've been kind of working my way into over the last year-ish. So I started out my reading a lot of YA fantasy, and I do love YA fantasy. It kind of brought me back into reading. I have found over the last year especially, I've been kind of moving away from it a little bit and being more interested in adult fantasy and what that genre has to offer, and it's been really fun to explore that. So I have read some of this genre before, but it is less familiar to me than some other types of fantasy books, so I thought it'd be fun to ask for your recommendations. I did read a lot of the ones that were highly recommended, or I have them on my shelves and I'm planning on reading them this year anyways, so I didn't pick up any of those obviously, but I did pick up one book off that list that I found really intrigued me, and that is called The Bridge Kingdom. I specifically mentioned when I was asking for adult fantasy recommendations that I really liked if there was a romance in the fantasy. The books that I read don't always have to have romance, but if I have like a favorite, it's adult fantasy with a romance in it. So when I mentioned that, the people who specifically recommended this book, it was recommended a couple of times, specifically pointed out that the romance is like really good. So that's primarily why I picked it up. And this is a series, which I'm excited about. So I believe that this is, again, an enemies to lover, that the female character is kind of a spy going into another kingdom, which I'm very intrigued about. The back of the book, like the synopsis, the first couple of lines really sold me on this. So it says, "What if you fell in love with the one person you'd sworn to destroy? Laura has only one thought for her husband on their wedding day. I will bring your kingdom to its knees." I'm really intrigued by that. I'm really excited about it. I can't wait to try this one, and I'm really happy that it was recommended to me, especially because I had never heard of this series before, so it's brand new. I have no idea what it's about. I've never really heard anyone talk about it, and I'm excited for this one. The last book that I hauled in January is another one that I am very excited about. It wasn't on my list of recommendations that I asked for you guys, but again, this is a book that was highly recommended to me just in general. In fact, I had a really good friend again tell me I had to read this, and I've heard a lot of people talking about it lately, and it has a lot of hype right now. And I was already really interested in it, but when I saw a couple of reviews on it talking about how they never saw the twists coming and that like the plot was insane, it really surprised them. That really got me, because for me, I'm a sucker for if a book will surprise me. I guess plot twists like all the time. It's really hard for me to be surprised in books, but I have seen multiple people say that this book had like the best plot twist. So that really intrigued me. The synopsis really intrigued me, but I'm mostly going off of how many people told me I need to read this book, and that is Legendborn. So this is a YA fantasy, so nothing new for me, but I am really excited about this book. Absolutely love the cover. So this book is at a like school setting. There's like secret society, there's demons, I think there's a romance. I don't know, it just sounds really up my alley. So I'm very excited about this one, especially with all the hype it's been getting lately. I'm actually going to be reading this one in February, so very soon. So I'm very excited to dive right into this one. Okay, so those are all of the books that I hauled in January, and they were all based on your recommendations. I love getting book recommendations, especially from you guys, because I feel like you guys know what you're talking about, and then I have like a reliable source that's telling me I'm gonna like it. I'm really excited to get into those books. I'm really excited to check out some new genres that I'm not really familiar with. So I will keep you posted on how I was feeling about all of those books. Maybe I'll do like a reading vlog, or I'll do like a specific wrap up talking about when I read all these books. I would love to know if you guys have any further recommendations for these types of genres. Leave a comment down below and let me know. I'd also love to know the last book that you hauled, whether it was a book you bought or maybe a book you got from the library. Leave a comment down below and let me know. Finally, I just wanted to mention, if you're interested in seeing that spreadsheet and all of the results, I will leave a link to it down below. I did recently ask on my Instagram, I'm doing an updated one for YA fantasy, YA contemporary, and nonfiction books. So I will be compiling all of those answers pretty soon and updating that spreadsheet. So if you want to see the results of those, you can check out the spreadsheet. I just wanted to say thank you so much for watching. If you're not already subscribed to my channel, be sure to hit that button, and you can hit the notification bell if you want to be notified every time I upload. Also, if you enjoyed this video, I would love if you would give it a thumbs up. Like I said, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.